Bob, is the monetary policy overcompensating for the lack of fiscal stimulus, do you think?
No, I don't think so. I think monetary policy got exactly to where it's supposed to be, which is you've had a crisis the likes no one has ever seen. Central banks have thrown everything at it that they could. They've cut rates to zero or negative. They're expanding balance sheet. They're providing liquidity facilities. They should just drop the mic and walk off stage and say, job done. It's going to take years for the output gap to close. What will speed that along is adequate fiscal response, and that's what's missing now. So I think the narrative has shifted from monetary policy to fiscal policy this month.
Bob, in the absence of fiscal stimulus, monetary policy steps in, and we're lower, and for how much longer?
Well, that's a really good question. And I know you covered negative real yield. And it's a reminder that that government bond yields are actually anything central banks want them to be. And right now they want them to be negative on a real yield basis. And they're looking at a choppy recovery. We'll see how the reopening goes. I think they're also looking at the trillions of dollars of debt that are being piled onto all levels of government, to businesses, and to households, and wondering how long will it take to repay that. So to answer your question, let's start with the 7 years it took the Fed to raise rates after the financial crisis. Remember, they went to zero December 2008, and they first raised rates December 2015. Maybe they learned a little bit from then. They could, you know, maybe have done it a couple years earlier. But I think the severity of this crisis and the unknowns out there, 7 years is a pretty good target in mind.
Bob, it's interesting. We've been range-bound in 10 years, 50 to 70 basis points or so in the past few months. What will it take to go significantly below 50 basis points, in your opinion?
Well, I think it will take a significant decline in either inflation or economic activity. And both of those things are possible. We'll see how the transition to an economy that's reopened at a fraction of what it used to look like pre-crisis, how all of that unfolds. If that leads to a risk-off environment and profit-taking in a lot of the sectors that had benefited, yeah, you could see money take Treasury yields down to zero.